First of all, it was a very interesting movie and great action sequences. I was just wondering, are you planning to develop this into a feature? Because there was a lot more to be told, it looks like.
Actually, being a minority Asian, it's really tough in Hollywood. So I figure, you know, I'm gonna have my friends that are writers. They would write scripts, and I wanted to put together a script that talks about an Asian character. Because you know, everyone knows who James Bond is. Everyone knows who Jason Bourne is. But they never know. You never know how these guys become who they are. So I just want to develop a character where you can see his journey become, you know, the badass that he is. But obviously, I didn't have a vehicle, so I had the script written called Cody and the Dragon, but I wanted to introduce the character, and my buddy Charlie Sharp here, he wanted to direct a film because he's directing music videos, and he had his all my action, whether it's movies or fights, so I can put it on social media. And then he said, hey, I get some reds. I'm like, how much are the reds? Yeah, about 150. I'm like, who's gonna pay for it? He's like, you. So I said, all right, you gonna direct this? And he's like, yeah. And I'm like, so what are we gonna do? He's like, I don't know. So I figure I'll introduce my character, and so I ended up writing the script, and I want to introduce this character that where he's already the badass. And I talked to my wife and I said, hey, honey, they went out to spend some money to put this project together, and she was completely behind me. She thought, just don't go over a certain amount. I won't say it. It's actually pretty good, and thank you, honey. And I just started calling all my friends, Danielle and Chuck, started putting a team together to film the movie, and then we ended up getting this movie made. It's been a tough journey with this movie, from getting the footage together, the editing, and then one of the actors who's actually a director, John Brody, he directed that last sequence with Russell Peters and myself, and he was gonna be here tonight, but his brother died, but he made sure that before he was gonna leave to the funeral, he finished this film. So literally, Danielle stayed in LA, she lives in San Diego, and waited for him to finish the edit so it can make it here and to show it to you guys. And it got here, come hell or high water, and we got Codename the Dragon and Morgan Creek Films right now, and Dash Films. They're in negotiation to make the prequel of this to show how Logan Lee became the badass that he is. So just want to thank everyone for showing up tonight. My mom, and it's been a crazy journey. You know, we are refugees, and now we're my mom and my wife be my backbone and taking care of everything at home and making sure the kids are safe. I love you. And to everyone here, I see a lot of old students. It's almost like I feel like we should start class and do cardio and punch and kick each other. And we got Smash Gyms here, my new, the gym that I'm behind, and the fastest growing gym in the Bay Area, and soon to be the world. And it's just, I think the sky's the limit. And it's not, you can't let anyone dictate, you know, what your career is gonna be. You just gotta step up, and you gotta do it yourself, and you gotta believe in it, and you or die trying. It's just like, it's like you go into a fight, like when I go into a fight, they gotta kill me in order to beat me. I'll go out on my shield, and that's how I put this mentality together. I'm gonna die trying, so. If not, after parties at Studio 8, it's going to get crazy. It's going to get weird.
Does anyone in the audience have questions? Okay, come down. Was the choice, was it your decision to wear the Bruce Lee shirt, if I saw that correctly in the film?
Bruce Lee, he's the one who opened the doors for all the Asian actors and the martial artists out there, so I figure, you know, how to represent and honor him in, you know, in any way I could, so I wore the Bruce Lee shirt. I think I wear it too much. My wife's always, you gotta wear a different shirt. I'm like, I got 10 of them, honey, but, you know, 35. So, yes, it was my choice.
Anybody else?
Shy here.
All right, Con, what game was that you were playing? On your phone.
Clash of Clans.
Okay.
All the questions you guys got, really? Come on.
So the next question's for Arash. One of the parts of the movie that really stuck out in my mind was when you were laughing that Logan was still alive.
Yeah.
What's your state of mind or thought process when you were like acting that role, or when you were like either scripting, or what's going on in your head during that?
That's a brilliant question. First, I think the first thing I want to say is that because Bruce Lee came up, in 1986, Enter the Dragon came out and it changed the world. The world got to see an Asian actor for the first time not be portrayed as the chop-chop teeth, but a badass. Since then, Jet Li and Jackie Chan have taken the lead. And now we have Kung Lee. And I've known Kung for many years. He's proven himself in many different areas. And I see what Bruce Lee did in the same tradition is what Kung Lee is doing. And I think it should be acknowledged that the world does need a representative of the Oriental culture. Bruce Lee called it Oriental, not Asian, because the Oriental culture is beautiful. Dragons and emperors and samurai and shogun, right? So first, let me acknowledge that, and that I see the future. The world does need a Kung Lee in the tradition of Bruce. I'm here because of Bruce Lee. Kung's here because of Bruce Lee. We're all here because of Bruce Lee. And so in that tradition, it should be acknowledged that the present time world should recognize that we do need another hero. Now, in regards to your question, thank you for that. The laughter. My teacher was Manu Tupou, one of the greatest artistic directors in Hollywood. And what he taught me was, in acting, it's organic living, you see? So when I laughed, I laughed. And I laughed at the absurdity of life and the fact that everybody's always acting. I just happen to have a camera in front of me. So it would be like this.
He's a traditional martial artist, and that's his foundation. He's a champion inside and out. And it's not often that you get to see a lot of the UFC fighters with such intelligence. And I mean that with, you know, I have friends that do fight in the UFC, and I admire their tenacity and their determination, their commitment, because it takes a lot to get ready for a fight. It's not just the fight, it's the process. It's the getting to the fight. And the fact that he does that and then withstands a fight and goes out, like he says, on a shield, win or lose, he does the very same thing in life and in the film industry. And not in just being a minority, but just being a person in it, it's not the easiest. And at this point when we're sitting here, it looks like glamorous and it looks so easy, but it's very difficult. And I so admire him in that process and, you know, being a part of it and getting to be beside him and work beside him. I was really taken back at what a true champion he is. And, you know, when you're around him and you're talking to him, you forget that he's this fighter, because he's just a fighter in life, in love, and being a father. And he's really, you know, he's a class act. And I've been very humbled by everybody on this production and everybody in this business, because, you know, it's a big family. And I really believe in, the only thing we control is our attitude and our efforts. And when you put them all together and you're aiming for an end goal in common, you come out and you do not good, but you do great things. And I'm just really glad to be here and with all of you. And really, I feel very special to be able to sit by him. Of course, I fought him off for the seat, but no, I really do. And I thank you for including me in this project.
First things first, I just wanted to say you guys had an amazing film. I was into it the whole time. My question is for Kung. My question is, you know, for the action sequences, what's the thought process going through those action sequences, and just how did you make it look so good?
Well, it's not just me. It's also the stunt team. And the only fight scene that we got a chance to rehearse was that group fight. Everything else was like that day. Like Ron, he was supposed to just come in and have a big gun fight, but we needed you know, someone I can fight, and Ron
was, he was too afraid to fight me, so he fought Ron instead.
So Ron stepped up, and then we just put a couple of, you know, fight beats together, and then I don't want this character just to run through everyone. I want him to be clever. I want him to, you know, be, yeah, he's not the best fighter out there or the best gun, you know, the marksman out there, but he uses his mind to win the fights along with his physicality. And, you know, we just put it together and hope for the best, and it turned out pretty good.
Great. Thank you very much, everyone, for coming here tonight. And just a round of applause again.
Before we leave, I know Sharp here had something to say. You know, he's definitely, you know, for me, I didn't want to direct at all. I just wanted to do all the action. But, you know, he stepped up and he directed a lot. And I jumped in there and directed all the action. And, you know, whenever I get a chance, whenever I'm not acting, helped him out, but you know, he definitely, you know, pulled his weight.
Thank you, sir. So I just want to say, you know, I've worked with Kung for like 6 years or so now. You know, been watching him, you know, grow over the years as far as you know, as an actor, and I've seen a lot. You know, we've done so many things together as far as you know, auditions and just different things, and I've seen him, you know, like this film, I think. I told him he really was able to, you know, show his range. I think, you know, he's always like, you know, been a tough guy, and he's a great bad guy, great badass. But he really has a lot to offer, and I can't wait to see what's next. You know, he has a lot coming. He's just getting started, so I just wanted to say that, and I appreciate everything that he's done for me, and he's really, you know, put me in a position to grow as a filmmaker. So. Thank you for that, Kung. And yes, definitely look out for more. There's a lot more coming, so.
Thank you. Thank you all very much.